What are the best methods for reducing ketones to alcohols? This is an important organic transformation because ketones are readily available synthetic intermediates and alcohols are also useful intermediates and valuable target compounds. Ketones can be reduced easily with hydrides of boron, aluminum or silicon, and these reactions will not be discussed here. All the reagents presented in the videos about the reduction of carboxylic acids to alcohols can also be used to reduce ketones and aldehydes, often under still milder conditions. This video is the first of a series of 4 presentations about the reduction of ketones by strategies which are usually not applicable to carboxylic acids. These are catalytic hydrogenations with catalysts optimized for ketones, the reduction by alkali and other metals, the Meerwein-Ponndorf-Verley reduction, and the enantioselective reduction by boranes. Carbonyl groups are usually more difficult to hydrogenate than olefins or nitro groups. But with the right catalyst, ketones undergo clean hydrogenation under mild conditions. In recent years, a large number of catalysts were developed which enable the enantioselective reduction of ketones, and a number of such reactions are even being run on an industrial scale. These catalytic hydrogenations proceed by intermediate formation of a metal hydride which is sufficiently nucleophilic to add hydride to the ketone. In order to act as a catalyst, the metal-oxygen bond must be weak enough to permit regeneration of the metal hydride upon reaction of the metal alkoxide with hydrogen. From the few metals which fulfill these requirements, ruthenium is the most commonly used. Some catalysts also contain ligands capable of simultaneously activating the carbonyl group by hydrogen bond formation to facilitate hydride addition. Most of the catalysts suitable for the hydrogenation of ketones will also decompose formic acid or its salts into hydrogen and carbon dioxide, and the hydrogenations of this presentation can usually also be performed with formic acid as hydrogen source. Catalytic hydrogenations have many advantages if compared to other types of chemistry. These include the absence of any stoichiometric waste and the low cost of hydrogen. With current catalysts, ketones can often be reduced with high enantioselectivity and with very small amounts of catalyst. The mild reaction conditions and the high selectivity of most catalysts make this reaction suitable also for complex starting ketones containing a number of other functional groups. Unfortunately, some catalysts require strong bases or acids as co-catalysts, what makes the workup of such hydrogenations slightly more complicated and limits the scope of suitable starting ketones. Then, homogeneous hydrogenations always require some kind of workup to remove the catalyst from the product. These catalysts are often very expensive, but as shown on the next slides, small amounts of catalyst can be sufficient to attain acceptable conversion rates. This is a typical example of an enantioselective ketone hydrogenation with a ruthenium-based catalyst. With an incredibly small amount of catalyst, a very high enantioselectivity was attained, without any hydrogenation of the olefin or CO bond hydrogenolysis. Because of the low catalyst loading, however, a complete conversion of the starting material took 43 hours. Reduction of other functional groups, such as epoxides, olefins, nitroarenes, cyclopropanes, or 1-chloroketones by this catalyst are very slow and do usually not compete with ketone hydrogenation. This is an example of a dynamic kinetic resolution with a similar catalyst as in the previous example. This catalyst hydrogenates only one of the 2 enantiomers of the racemic starting ketone to yield the main product. The other enantiomer of the starting ketone is quickly epimerized by the base so that a complete conversion of the starting ketone into an enantiomerically and diastereomerically pure alcohol can be attained. This is a further example of enantioselective hydrogenation of an aromatic ketone. iridium and the required ligand are very expensive, but by increasing the reaction temperature slightly, a complete conversion of the starting ketone could be achieved in 18 hours with only 0.002% of catalyst. 1,3-dicarbonyl compounds are CH acidic and form rather unreactive salts when treated with bases. These enolates are good ligands and many undergo ligand exchange with other metal complexes. Therefore, the catalytic hydrogenation of 3-ketoesters is best conducted in the presence of acids to prevent salt formation and ligand exchange. In this instance, a ketoester was hydrogenated enantioselectively, again with only traces of a ruthenium catalyst. Because noble metals are expensive, more affordable alternatives are being sought after. One possibility is the use of iron-based catalysts, as shown on this slide. Unfortunately, a relatively expensive diphosphine ligand was required to prevent the formation of iron oxides or alkoxides, but maybe in the future less expensive ligands can be found. This is an example of a heterogeneous hydrogenation with platinum as catalyst. Interestingly, despite the acidic reaction conditions, no benzylic CO bond cleavage occurred. In this instance, however, the benzylic carbocation would be strongly destabilized by the adjacent ammonium cation, what may be the reason for the high yield of benzylic alcohol obtained. Finally, in this example, only high temperatures and a strong base, but no transition metal catalyst, were used for the hydrogenation of benzophenone. Because most ketones are readily deprotonated or cleaved by strong bases, the scope of this procedure is probably narrow. But from a mechanistic viewpoint, this reaction is certainly interesting and could lead to the development of completely new strategies for the reduction of ketones. So, what are the potential side reactions? With most catalysts, ketones can be hydrogenated quite selectively, and few other functional groups will be reduced simultaneously. Occasionally, though, as in the example on this slide, highly reactive allylic or benzylic alcohols may result as intermediates, which can be easily reduced to alkanes. If rhodium catalysts are used, olefins and arenes may also be hydrogenated, but with ruthenium catalysts, this is usually not observed. In addition to aldehydes, imines and imenium salts may also undergo hydrogenation along with ketones. Therefore, the hydrogenation of ketones should ideally not be carried out in the presence of primary or secondary amines. It has also been observed that some nitriles may be hydrated to amides under the conditions used for ketone hydrogenation. Here are some more newer examples and review articles. To conclude, catalytic hydrogenation is one of the most inexpensive and cleanest methods for the reduction of ketones. Of course, for a quick laboratory preparation, a reduction with sodium borohydride is much easier to perform. But for larger scale preparations or for industrial applications where costs and environmental considerations are critical, hydrogenation is often the method of choice. Only when a given ketone contains sulfur or chelating groups which poison every hydrogenation catalyst or other functional groups incompatible with hydrogenations, alternative methods must be considered. These will be presented in the following videos.